friends, we'll go with a very important problem as per the exam point of view on arbitrary range. So this is very important problem. Many times it has come in the exam. So we'll go through this problem. If f of x is equals to, the function has been divided into 2 in the range minus 3 by 2 to 0 and 0 to 3 by 2. Hence, deduce that pi square by 8 is equals to 1 upon 1 square plus 1 upon 3 square plus 1 upon 5 square. So, as per the given problem, we are having an open interval because here it is less than. So, less than means it is going to come it as an open interval and the range is from negative to positive. That is minus 3 by 2 to plus 3 by 2. They have not told in the problem to find the Fourier series, means it is understood it is a full range series. So again compute L as 2L is equals to upper limit minus the lower limit. In such case I will get L is equals to 3 by 2. Now I'll check for even and odd concept. So when we are checking for even and odd concept and when the function has been divided into two range, I have given you in the last of my videos how to check for even and odd. When the function has been divided into two ranges, take one function as phi of x, second function you take it as psi of x. So when I take phi of x as 1 plus 4x by 3 and psi x is equals to 1 minus 4x by 3, I will try to replace x by minus x in either one of the function. I will try to substitute in phi of x. Why I am replacing it as x by minus x? Because my range is from negative to positive. So where all x is a substitute minus x, I am seeing that phi of minus x has come equals to what? Psi of x. Means the function is even. So when the function is even, we are going to compute, then we are going to say that here a naught and an we are going to compute and bn is equals to 0. So now we need to compute for a naught. How to compute a naught? A naught is computed as, since we have checked for even and odd, it will become 2 by L integral 0 to L f of x dx. 2 L is 3 by 2 integral 0 to 3 by 2 f of x dx. Now the function has been divided into two ranges. Now what are you going to substitute f of x value? So to substitute f of x value, here my limits are from 0 to 3 by 2. So consider the function in the range 0 to 3 by 2. What is the function? 1 minus 4x by 3. So this function must be substituted over here. So 1 minus 4x by 3 is integration we need to perform. This 2 will go up, so 4 by 3. Separately I have to integrate. Integration of 1 is x. 4 by 3 is acting as a constant, write it as it is. X integration is x square by 2. Limits ranging from 0 to 3 by 2. Upper limit minus the lower limit. Upper limit is 3 by 2. This 2 by 3. 3 by 2 means 9 by 4. 9 by 4 means 2 1s are 2 2s are 3 1s are 3 3s are. So 3 by 2. Lower limit is at least 0. So a naught is 0. Next, I'll compute for an. So, an formula is 2 by L integral 0 to L f of x cos n pi x upon L dx. L is 3 by 2. Function defined is 1 minus 4x by 3. L is 3 by 2. So, numerators, denominators, denominator will come in the numerator. So, this becomes 2n pi x upon 3. Need to apply u into v rule, that is Bernoulli's. 4 by 3 as it is, 1 minus 4x by 3 as it is, integration of cos 2n pi x upon 3 will become sin 2n pi x upon 3 upon 2n pi by 3 minus, differentiation of 1 is 0, minus 4 by 3 is acting as a constant, derivative of x is 1, 1 into 4 by 3 it is 4 by 3, so 0 minus 4 by 3. 1 upon 2n pi upon 3 is acting as a constant, so write it over here. Integration of sin 2n pi x upon 3 will become minus cos 2n pi x upon 3 upon 2n pi by 3. Derivative has turned out to constant, so stop the procedure and write 0 to 3 by 2. So after finishing, simplify the signs. This minus and this minus will make it plus. Plus into minus is minus. This 3 will come in the numerator, so it will become 3 upon 2n pi. This 3 threes are 9. 9 threes are here. 9 will come in the numerator, so 9 fours are 36. 3 twos are 6. 6 twos are 12. N square, pi square, and this term will remain. So we need to substitute upper limit minus the lower limit. When we substitute upper limit minus the lower limit, we are remained with the terms 4 by 3 minus 36 upon 12 n square pi square cos n pi plus 36 upon 12 n square pi square cos 0. 3 ones are here 12 ones are 12 threes are 3 3 will get cancelled. 4 upon n square pi square will remain as it is. Cos n pi value is minus 1 raised to n with the negative sign plus 1. This negative sign will be raised power plus 1. So this is what an. Hence your Fourier series will become f of x equals to a naught by 2 plus summation n equals to 1 to infinity an cos n pi x upon l. So a naught is 0, an is 4 upon n square pi square minus 1 raised to n plus 1 plus 1 cos n pi x upon 3 by 2. This 2 will come above. Okay, so this is what the Fourier series, which I am marking it as 1. They have asked us to deduce for the series pi square by 8 is equals to 1 upon 1 square plus 1 upon 3 square plus 1 upon 5 square. As discussed in my previous videos, I have told you this has come a cosine series. So start your substitution of x value as 0. So when you are substituting x as 0, first you check whether the function is continuous or no. So as per a defined function, if you see, the function is continuous because it is lying in between range. And hence, directly substituting in place of x, 0 in f of x. Now, since f of x has been divided into two ranges, here it has been divided into two ranges. Which function you are going to use to calculate the value of f of 0? In this case, you can use any one of this function. That is 1 plus 4x upon 3 or 1 minus 4x upon 3. Here, always we consider the positive range. So, I will consider f of x is equals to 1 minus 4x upon 3. So, where all x is a substitute 0. So, 1 minus 4 into 0 upon 3. That is f of 0 is 1. So, my equation 2 becomes f of 0 summation n equals to 1 to infinity 4 upon n square pi square minus 1 raised to n plus 1 plus 1 cos 0. Cos 0 is 1. So, f of 0 is 1. This 4 upon pi square will come out. So, 4 upon pi square summation n equals to 1 to infinity 1 upon n square into minus 1 raised to n plus 1 plus 1 will remain here. So, when I am simplifying for this, here I will get further. This 4 will go this side. This 4 will go this side. That is in the comes in the denominator. Pi square will go in the numerator. So, pi square by 4 is equals to summation n equals to. Now, here I have restricted this bracket by writing the value. Here, if I take n as 1, that is 1 plus 1, it is 2. Minus 1 raised to 2, it is plus 1. Plus 1 plus 1, it will be 2. Means for all odd numbers, the value is becoming 2. So, this I have written 2 and I have restricted the summation for n equals to 1, 3, 5 and so on. 1 upon n square as it is. So, this 2 will come outside the summation and that will come this side. So, it will become pi square by 8. Summation n equals to 1, 3, 5, so on, 1 upon n square. When we substitute n as 1, 3, 5, we will get our required deduction and hence the problem solution. Thank you.